ಏನು ಮಾರ್ಕರ್ಸ್ ತೆಚ್ಚೋ ಮಾರ್ಕರ್ಸ್ ಓಕೆ next so yesterday I explained to you basic points of the equatorial triangle okay I'm going to explain the how do we calculate resultant force on the equilateral triangle okay suppose for example this is a this is a equilateral triangle this charge is positive charge this is another positive charge this is a one more charge we have to calculate resultant force on any corner of the charge resultant forces we have to calculate we have to calculate resultant force on any charge ikkada we have three charges this is one charge this is another charge this is one more charge ఈ ఈక్వటోరియల్ ట్రయాంగిల్లో ఇక్కడ ఒక చార్జ్ ఉంది ఇక్కడ ఒక చార్జ్ ఉంది ఇక్కడ ఒక చార్జ్ ఉంది అయితే వి హావ్ టు క్యాల్కులేట్ రిజల్టెంట్ ఫోర్స్ ఆన్ ఎనీ వన్ ఆఫ్ ద చార్జ్ దీని మీదైనా రిజల్టెంట్ ఫోర్స్ కనుక్కోవచ్చు లేకపోతే దీని మీదైనా రిజల్టెంట్ ఫోర్స్ క్యాల్కులేట్ చేయొచ్చు లేదు అనుకుంటే దీని మీదైనా రిజల్టెంట్ ఫోర్స్ క్యాల్కులేట్ చేయొచ్చు okay now we have to calculate resultant force on any one of the charge yelante suppose for example I want to find out the resultant force acting on this charge on q charge distance between the two charges is a initial charges next this positive charge repel to the charge this is a F1 force ee positive charge this is a positive charge ee positive charge ni repel chestundi ee direction that is a force number F1 alane similar ga ee charge ఈ చార్జ్ ఆప్షన్స్ లో పెట్టుకుంటే ఈ చార్జ్ ని ఈ డైరెక్షన్స్ లో రిపెల్ చేస్తుంది దట్ ఇస్ ఆఫ్ ఫోర్స్ నెంబర్ F ఈ చార్జ్ ఇది పాజిటివ్ చార్జ్ ఈ చార్జ్ ని ఈ డైరెక్షన్ లో రిపెల్ చేస్తుంది అప్పుడు ఇది ఆప్షన్ అవుతుంది నెక్స్ట్ సెకండ్ సిచ్యుయేషన్ లో ఇది ఆప్షన్ లో పెడితే ఈ పాజిటివ్ చార్జ్ రిపెల్ చేస్తే రెండు ఫోర్స్ ఈ డైరెక్షన్స్ లో ఇది ఎఫ్ అని ఇది ఎఫ్ దిస్ ఇస్ అ ఈక్వటోరియల్ ట్రయాంగిల్ మీన్స్ ఆల్ కార్నర్స్ హ్యావింగ్ 60 degrees ఇలా 60 degrees కలిగి ఉంటుంది దిస్ ఇస్ ఆపోజిట్ సైడ్ దిస్ ఆల్సో 60 degrees 60 degrees ఉంటుంది ఓకేనా క్లియర్ okay here you see apply the coulomb's inverse law here e charge ki madhya coulomb's law apply chesthe force is f2 is equal to medium 1/4 pi epsilon naught charge 1 q charge 2 q by distance a a square, that is a force between the two charges. So next, the E side of chess, Coulomb's law apply chest, F1 is equal to K, Q and Q, Q square, distance is, from distance is A, A square. This is Coulomb's law. Coulomb's law apply chest. You see carefully, F2 is equal to K, Q into Q, A square. Q into Q, A square. F2 is equal to K into Q square by A square. F1 also, K into Q square by A square. You see carefully, F1 is equal to F2 is equal to F. Both all are same. F is, I mean, F1 is equal to F2 is equal to, I am taking F. Rendu force kuda equal F. Ikkada equal forces. Now, theta is equal to 60 degrees. So, but what we have to do here, we have to find out resultant force on the charge. What is the resultant force? Resultant force is equal to question mark. We know according to parallelogram. So what is the parallelogram law? Resultant force is equal to root of a square plus b square plus 2ab cos theta. Cos theta. Here a means f1, b means f2, c means f. We can take resultant force. What happened? Yeah, F1 is equal to F, F2 is equal to F else. F1 is equal to F, F2 is equal to F else. I'm taking here. Resultant force means FR is equal to root of A means F square, B means F square plus 2AB means F square cos 60 degrees. FR is equal to root of 2f square plus 2f square cos 60 1 by 2. Cos 60 1 by 2. To cancel each other. So what we get? Fr is equal to root of 2f square plus f square. We are getting root of 3f square. You can write this is a root 3f. This is a FR resultant force we are getting. This is a final answer. How can you write this one? Means FR is equal to root 3 F. But F means, you can write F1 is equal to F2 is equal to F. You can write to any magnitude. F2 is equal to F1, F, you can write any one equation, F means. This is a root 3 F, F means K Q squared by A square. K means K is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon. You can write 4 pi epsilon naught Q squared A square. This is a F resultant on any one charge. That is our answer. Your answer is that one. Alane. ఈ రెండు చార్జెస్ వచ్చేసి దీని మీద యాక్ట్ అయ్యే రిజల్టెంట్ ఫోర్స్ సేమ్ ఆన్సర్. క్లియర్ అర్థమవుతుందా? ఏమంటుందా అంటే ఈ చార్జ్ దీని మీద యాక్ట్ అవుతుంది, ఈ చార్జ్ దీని మీద యాక్ట్ అవుతుంది, రిజల్టెంట్ ఫోర్స్ ఇక్కడ రిజల్టెంట్ ఫోర్స్ మనం క్యాల్కులేట్ చేసాం. అలా కాకుండా ఇప్పుడు ఐ వాంట్ టు ఫైండ్ అవుట్ రిజల్టెంట్ ఫోర్స్ ఆన్ ది చార్జ్ మీన్స్ యు ఆర్ గెటింగ్ సేమ్ ఆన్సర్. We have to find out resultant force on this charge means you are getting same. Today, we have to find out resultant force any charge. A charge means the resultant force calculated, we are getting that is the answer. That is the resultant force. Okay? Keep in your mind, very shortcut. The 60 degrees means FR is equal to root 3 F. Keep in your mind this one. Both are equal values. You can take one. Next, second question. But finally, resultant force, which direction? Resultant force, which direction? Resultant force is, this is a F1, this is a F2, this is a 60 degrees. Resultant force is this one. F1 is this one. Upward direction. That is very, very, very important. Resultant force is upward. F1 force, this is F1, this is F2, resultant force is upward direction. This is a resultant force, upward direction. Now let's keep in our mind. This is a direction. This is a magnitude. So force is a vector, and vector means physical quantities which are having magnitude and direction. Magnitude is this one. Direction is this one. Actually, this is a F1 force direction. This is F2 direction. But resultant force, direction of resultant force is upward direction. Upward direction. Am I clear? That's all. Next, the second question. Second point. Now, this time, I'm going to take the equilateral triangle. This is a positive charge. This is a positive charge. This is a negative charge. Now, we have to find out resultant force on minus Q. We have to calculate resultant force on minus Q. So, what is it? We have to find out resultant force on minus Q charge. Minus Q charge. If this is an equilateral triangle, all colors having 60, 60, 60 mark. Okay. Here, this is a positive charge. Positive charge. This positive charge will attract negative charge this direction. This is a F1 force. This is a distance A. Distance is A. This is a distance A. Distance between the charges is A. This positive charge will attract negative charge towards this direction. The time this positive charge is absent. Absent. Emma? Positive charge will attract negative charge towards this direction. Apply the Coulomb's law. So F1 is equal to medium between the two charges is K. Q and minus Q. Minus Q taken as positive charge. Already I told you very clearly. Q squared by A squared. That is a F1. Next, F2 force. This is absent. The charge is absent. The charge. This is a positive charge. This is a negative charge. This positive charge will attract negative charge towards this direction. That is a F2 force. Coulomb's inverse curl applies between the two charges. Medium between the two charges K. Two charges. This is positive. This is a negative. Negative charge is taken as positive when we are calculating the resultant force time. Already I told you. Negative charge is taken as positive when we are going to solve the resultant force. When we are going to solve the resultant problems. Minus Q is taken as positive charge. Also, charge Q is Q, Q squared by, and the distance is A squared. This is a F1, F2 force. But you see the magnitude, F1 is equal to F2 is equal to both are same direction. Same direction. This is F1, this is F2. What is angle here? 60 degrees. You know very well, F1 is equal to F2 is equal to F. Theta is equal to 60. So what is the resultant force? Root 3 of. That is a resultant force. Before only we have to do this problem. So F4 is equal to root 3 of. F means we can write F2 or F4, whatever. F1 is equal to F2 is equal to F. F means K Q squared by A squared. This is a resultant force. That is a resultant force. We have to find out direction of resultant force. This is a magnitude of resultant force. But direction of resultant force we have to calculate. This is a magnitude is forward. Direction of resultant force. You see carefully at this point, this is a force, F1. This is a force, F2. this is angle is 60 degrees. These two forces are combined, F1, F2, both are combined, what we are getting? Fr. You can write, this is a Fr, this is a F2, this is 60, angle is 60, you are getting Fr resultant is, this is Fr resultant force. Direction is downward direction. Reason is F1, F2. F1 is this side, F2 is this side. Resultant force is downward direction. Before problem, this is a negative charge means direction is down. Before is, this is a positive charge. Direction is, direction of resultant force is upward direction. There is a difference between the two problems. You see that clear. This is a very, very, very important one. మీకు పాజిటివ్ చార్జ్ పాజిటివ్ చార్జెస్ వాల్యూస్ నెగటివ్ చార్జెస్ వాల్యూస్ ఇస్తారు మీకు ఫైండ్ అవుట్ చేస్తారు. దిస్ ఇస్ వన్ మోడల్. నెక్స్ట్ సెకండ్ మోడల్. Next, this is a equilateral triangle. Here charges I am taking, this is a positive, this also positive charge, here also positive charges. Positive charges. This is a negative charges I am taking. Negative charges I am taking. This is a positive charge. This is another positive charge. This is negative charge. We have to find out the resultant force on acting the charge. Resultant force is acting on this corner. This corner. Resultant force is acting on this corner. Okay. Now, what I am going to do here, this negative charge is opposite. Negative charge is absent. Negative charge is upset. This positive charge, this is positive charge, this is also positive charge. This positive charge will repel to this positive charge, this direction. This is a force number one. Distance is M. Distance between the two charges A. This negative charge is absent. Positive charge will repel to this positive charge this direction, that is F1 force. Applies the pull. F1 is equal to medium is between the two charges is 1/4 pi epsilon naught, that is A. Two charges, positive, Q into Q, Q squared by distance is A squared. This is F1. Next to positive charge is opposite. Positive charge is absent. Positive charge is offset. And in negative charge, this is a negative charge, this is a positive charge. This negative charge will attract positive charge this direction. This is the force F2. Force F2. Next, F2 is equal to medium between the two charges K. Minus Q is taken as positive. This is positive. Positive into positive. Q squared. By A squared. Already I told you very clearly, minus Q is taken as positive charge. When we are going to solve the resultant force. Okay, that's why I am taking here positive charge. Okay, now this is F2 force. You see clearly, F1 is equal to K into Q squared by A squared. F2 is equal to K into Q squared by A squared. Both are F1 is equal to F2 is equal to F also. But you see, this is a F1 force, this is a F2 force. But what is the angle here? 120 degrees. Angle is 120 degrees. This part is taken outside. This is a F1 force, this is a F2 force. Angle is 120 degrees. Okay, we know we have to find out the resultant force is equal to root of F1 square plus F2 square plus 2 F1 F2 cos theta. Cos theta. F1 means you can write both mandatory. F1 is equal to F2 is equal to F. F1 is equal to F2 is equal to F. F. Why means? Here F1 is equal to K into Q squared by S squared. Here F2 is equal to K into Q squared by S squared. That's why F1 is equal to F2 is equal to F I am taking. F1 means you can take F squared. F2 means F. 2 into F1 means you can take F also. F2 means I'm taking F. Cos angle between the two forces. F1, F2, what is angle? Cos 120. This is a resultant force. Resultant force is equal to root of FF squared. So F squared plus 2 into F F squared. Cos 120, I'm writing cos 180 minus cos 180 minus 60. That is, you can write 120 cos 120. Here FR is equal to root of 2 F squared plus 2 F squared cos 180. Cos 180. 180 means this is a second coordinate. In second coordinate, cos is minus sign. Minus, plus into minus, minus cos 60. Cos 60. Okay, now FR is equal to root of 2F squared minus minus 2F squared cos 60, 1 by 2. Cos 60, 1 by 2. And 2 cancel each other. 2 cancel each other. FR is equal to root of 2F squared. 2 cancel each other means minus F squared. FR is equal to root of 2F squared minus F squared. Value is F squared. Square root cancel. FR is equal to F. That is a resultant force. This is a magnitude of resultant force. Magnitude of resultant force. This is a magnitude of resultant force. Now, I want direction of resultant force. What is the direction of resultant force? Direction of resultant force is, this is your direction of resultant. This is a direction. What is a direction? This is a direction of resultant force. F1, F2, direction of resultant force. This symbol indicates direction of resultant force. Direction of resultant force. That is your answer. Today, so finally keep in your mind, very simple, here very shortcut. Shortcut, what is a shortcut means? Okay. Now, you can write. This is the F1 force, this is the F2 force, this is a 130 degrees means your answer is FR is called F. FR is called F, that is a shortcut. Remaining, this is a force, F1 force, this is F2 force, this is 60 means this is a resultant force is root 3 F. But the direction of resultant force is the upward. That is a resultant force direction. Direction of resultant force. Am I clear? But this is a positive charge. In case negative charge means the direction of resultant force is F1, F2. This is a FR resultant force. But the resultant force is root 3 F. That is a shortcut. This is a procedure. This is a shortcut. Next problem.
Next. This is your upcoming. This is our master church. This is our master church. This is the first one. This is a big warning. This is okay. Resultant forces, we have to appeal to resultant forces on big point charge. Right? Charge. This is a big point charge. We want to direct the resultant force on the charge. Resultant force and each other. Distance between me, this is a distance between two charges, is A. We know the master charge, in the other master charge, we know the distance. This is a master charge, this is another master charge. Distance between two charges, is A. Remember the A. This is a weak point. From here to here, distance is here. From here to here, distance is here. Here. This was a charge. Resultant force acting on each other. This was a charge. This is a first. This was a charge. Return to the charge. And then this charge is moving. That is the opposite. This force charge. And then which charge of this charge is upset. This force charge will refer to this Q distance. That is it. Here, your phone is going to get to this point of effect. And then take it up to this one. Your phone is going to say your phone is going to. Here, two charges. A introduced by five distance here by two. Here by two, also. That is the effort. Next, Coulomb's law is given these two charges. F2 is equal to 1 by A. Q to Q, used by distance A by two, also. You see, clearly, F1 is equal to A to Q squared by A by two. F2 is equal to A to Q squared by A by 2 whole square. That is F1 equal. F1 is equal to F2 equal to F. Both forces are equal means the resultant force is on the cap. Okay, in this slide, this is the F2 force. This is the F1 force. Resultant is the F2 minus F1. In this slide, only in this slide. Okay, now, play it out. You see, this is positive charge. In positive charge, in positive charge, in positive charge. Each charge. Upset, both charges are upset. If positive charge, two charges stay as a equal distance, that is the effort. You will charge the force, the effort. Each charge with the force. If positive charge, the charge is equal to the distance. Change control, that is what the effort. Distance here. Coulomb's law is there. F1 force. Q to Q, Q squared, meaning is A. Distance is A by 2 both. Next, each charge is opposite, both are opposite. And then you know each other. these two charges. It is positive charge. It is positive. It is positive charge. It's happening with the triple charge. How do you get the distance between the two charges, A by two? E will be equal to something. You have to use A. You will be equal to A square. Distance is A by two also. How do you get the two? Both forces are equal. Just E line. But what is the resultant force? This is the number of force. This is the vector force. Both of them are equal. F1 and F2 are equal. What is the resultant force? Is 0. One point is over. Next, using the positive charge. This positive charge, this is a positive charge. If positive charge, if positive charge is negative, your water is not equal. From A to A, this is root 3 by 2. So this is the point. According to by this, this is A by 2. This is the answer of A by 2. This is A. This is the distance. Root 3 by 2. Root 3 by 2. This positive charge, this positive. This positive charge, this positive charge is offset. This positive charge will be able to use this positive charge normally. Or what? After that, we use it. Now we will use the other principle. A is Q square. Root 3 by 2. This two charges. You know the charges. This is charge. This is charge. Positive charge. Positive charge. Q is coming. Meaning is A. Here you can see the distance is root 3 A by 2. That is the distance is 5. Distance is 5. Here finally, the half is A. Q is for A by 2. This is an inhibitor triangle. Positive charge, to judge or to judge is itself as a judge. Resultant forces acting on our second. Resultant forces acting on center charge. We have to find out resultant force on center charge. Center charge. Resultant force will be what? Resultant force will be what? You know basic points. What is the basic points? From here to here is A, B, C, the center wall. From here to here is OA is equal to OA distance is equal to OC distance. What is the distance here? AY moving. This is the basic point. If we later try it, this is a basic point. OA distance, OB distance is equal to OC distance is equal to AY moving. AY moving. Okay. Couple of the target distance between this is A. Now, the charges, and I will activate two charges. The remaining charges are opposite. Each charge, rule of law, opposite at all. Take a million charges to Q and rule of charges. Give me the result. This Q will refer to the charges dispatch. That is force. Okay. Next, the charges which are absent, the charges will be activated. Each charge, this is a false charge. This false charge will refer to this false charge dispatch. That is a force. Therefore, you have to. Okay. Next, this charge, the charges offset, the charges activated. This positive charge will repel to this positive charges downward direction. That is here. That is a F. Am I clear? Okay. Next, what we have to do here? This is a first. What is the angle between the one and it is how much? 120 degrees. In angle is 120 degrees. In angle is 120 degrees. And it will be two forces, 120 degrees. 120 degrees. 120 degrees. Here, what is the effort force? You can say effort force is equal. Is it effort force? What is the effort force? The effort force is Q and U. Q and U. Q is the distance. Q is the distance. Q is the distance. Q is the distance. A by 3 also. That is the effort force. Next to the effort force. This is the distance. A by 3. Charge of Q is Q. Q is the distance. Distance between the two charges is A by 2. A by 2. A by 2. A by 2. M3. Next is M3. M3 is equal to. From here to here, this is A by 2. 2 into 2. Q is by. Meaning is A. Distance between two charges is A by 3. All of them. You see, carefully, you have one. F1 is equal to A into Q squared by A by root 2. Q Next one. People need to try me. People need to try me. Q minus. This is Q. What is the resultant force acting on this center? Resultant force acting on center. Resultant force on center charge. Center charge. Okay. All right. So we have to say distance between the two touches is A. Our spectrum A and take like this. Okay. This is a negative charge. Negative charge. Here you see carefully. I'm going to draw the negative. Positive charge. From D to D, the distance is A by one day,
this is a constant.
This also charges will depend on this also this is this negative charge. This negative charge will attract the object upward direction. Upward direction. It is a force. It can try to have a force. Now, take a second. This is a tensor force. This is a tensor force. This is a tensor force. Now, what is happening between the two forces? What are the meanings? F1P, F3, what is happening between? What are the meanings? F1P, F3, what are the meanings? What are the meanings? Am I clear? Okay. Then F1 is equal to F2 is equal to F3 is equal to right F. Why means we can apply Coulomb's law first here. This positive charge, repetitive charge is this direction F1. From here to this distance is A1. You can apply Coulomb's law. A2 is equal to A2. This is A by 2. Also, I say F1. Next to this positive charge, will be equal to this positive charge. This is the distance. This is A by the whole thing. In fact, A, F2 is equal to 2 square by distance A by whole thing. Next to this is the negative charge. This is from A to A, this is A by whole thing. This is the negative charge. This is positive charge. This negative charge will act at positive this component. This is F3 is equal to A2. Minus 2 is taken as positive. Positive charge on the positive charge can be useful by distance A by A2. You see, A2 is useful by A2. Here, A2 is useful by A2. Here, A2 is useful by A2. F1, F3, A2 are all are same. Same thing. That's why your phone is for the F2 is for the F3. This is for the F1, F3 is for the F3. Now, this is the same. This is the process of gamma. And this is here, what we can use. This is the force. We know when we write it. This is a force, this is a force. We have this for the F3. How can we write this one? Already I told you very good. In the previous question. This is a yellow, this is your first angle, 100 degrees. 100 degrees is the 100 degrees is 100 degrees in the two forces. And resultant force is your first angle. Then, okay, this is the force. Both are in the same direction. Yam plus yam. Therefore, is total force is 0. Therefore, is 0. Resultant force is 2. F means you can write any forces. that is your resultant force. I'm going to translate 6A square. I'm going to translate here. F1 is 6A square. Now, next I'm going to explain this very, very important. Charges. Each of few objects. Let's add. The system is equilibrium. If not, what is value of charge? That's Q. Yes, that's the center. To make a system, it will be given. Very, very, very important. Now, see here. So, three charges each of Q are placed at three corners of an electric triangle. The system is equilibrium. If not, what is value of charge Q? Place at the center to make the system. We did this model. I explained first model. It will be later trial. First model. 60 degrees. F1 is going to root 3. F1 is going to be root 3. I explain root 3 of resultant forces. Root 3 of here. Resultant forces acting on any column of charge is root 3 of already. Suppose there is no Q. Here, this is another column of the charge. What is the resultant force on this charge now? You see, it is okay. What will it be? This Q will equal to this Q is down the left. This is clear? This is Q. This is two elements of the this is the one is good. Okay, now we have to do the one. What is it for each of the judgment that two is on the yes. Now we have to do the judgment. Okay, we can do some like this. Now you see the one is going to be the best. And then it's the resistance. But what is the resistance for the graphics?
Okay, that is the answer. This is very, very, very important model.
Next, the same model I'm going to explain tomorrow. Thank you. Now, next in the class will be stopped. Next chemistry class will be stopped. Thank you. Thank you.